Good afternoon, all the visitors. This is Pradeep Saini from Signode India. Welcome to the PACML live demo. We are showing a PACML theme here. We have mix of machines. We have partners, vendors. We'll take you through the process. It's starting from the first machine, Rollertainers. This is the HMI for Rollertainers. We show that the speed, we are running at 20 cartons a minute. This machine basically is filling the spices into the mono cartons. We can see the process here. The liner cartons in the knockdown stage, we are filling the magazine here. One by one, each of the mono carton is opened and that is fed. From there, we are opening the top. Each of the mono carton is glued from the bottom. Below flaps are compressed. And then we see the filling, the spice going into the mono carton. Again, this is a speed that we are maintaining for demo. The machine can go, we can increase the speed. Well, as you can see, each of the mono carton is filled. We have the spice going into the mono carton. The weighment is done. And we have a hopper. We are filling with an equal amount of weight every time. As we see here, the raw material, that's the spice, from the screw conveyor is fed into the hopper. The screw conveyor is taking all the masala. It's going into the hopper. From there, we are filling into the mono carton. Then we do the level check. Each of the mono carton, a level check is done to check what is the level for spice in the mono carton. So these liner cartons are glued from the top. We see the glue being applied. And then the top flaps are closed. That's fed into the compression conveyor where we see from top and bottom these cartons are conveyed. This conveyor, we can adjust the height as per the liner cartons. So we see these cartons going from the conveyor in the upright position and then traveling lengthwise. That's where the liner carton is falling and it's traveling lengthwise. The next exciting machine is Paravelox. This is the Delta Robo, which changes the orientation from length to width. So we see how it's sucking, how it's, the vacuum is operating on each of the liner cartons. It's changing the orientation. Of course, not to mention the speed, we can always ramp that. These cartons then get into the collation. Here we see the collation which is happening with the help of pusher. So we see the cartons being collated here. That's the first layer. Five cartons being pushed by the pusher into the collation. That's the collation table. We see five cartons already on the collation table. That's how the robo comes and picks the layer, which is 10 cartons. That's the arm movement from ABB. And that's how it's getting into the carton. So that's the fifth layer that's there in the carton. We have 60 such liner cartons into the case. We see the layer being formed again. Now once we have five cartons there, The sixth one ensure that the layer is ready and it is to be pushed into the accumulation. Here comes the robo. This is picked. The ABB robo operating at a speed which is safe. We can always increase this depending on the line speeds. Here we go. The carton is filled. It travels through the aligner interlocks conveyor into the ITW Signode taping machine. Top and bottom is taped. Again, it's on the interlocks conveyor where we change the orientation. It takes a turn from there and it is going to be now picked by a giant robo. The robo grabs. It grabs this carton. It goes up. It knows where to place this carton. We form the second layer on the pallet. We place the first carton as the shipper carton, second layer on the pallet. The robo is going to wait for the next carton to come in. Well, let's go back to this case packer robo where we see again the next carton being formed. We see the robo which is ready to pick the next layer. It picks it up. Picks it up, places into the carton, does it so precisely. The robo can be taught for different configurations. And needless to tell the speeds that it can go to. Well, obviously we can look at somewhere close to 100 picks in a minute. The layer is ready, robo comes, the vacuum sucks all these 10 cartons, the layer is taken, it's fed into the shipper, and here we go. This is the third layer. Let's look at what's the machine behind the case packer. There is a bottom sealer there. There we keep a carton. That's robo putting the fourth layer. We have a lot of visitors. And that's how we have the bottom sealer operating, the carton being fed manually. Of course, that operation we can do through carton erector. We can have the magazine fed there and carton erector. Okay, let's see the taping activity now. Top and bottom tape applied here. There comes the interlocks conveyor. That's going to be picked by the robo now. So we see the robo coming in. There is the grab. This is going to put the second carton on the second layer. And that's the teaching part of the robo, which we know that it's going to put it precisely next to the first carton. But let's look at the operation after this. as we see Robo putting these layers, we know the pallet is going to be made by the Robo. Once the pallet is ready, then we can see the wrapping machine which does the stretch wrapping. Wrapper being operated and the pallet being stretch wrapped. This is a wrapping machine which will wrap the pallet. This is an offline machine. We can have online wrapping. We can have this process online, where we wrap the pallet, the desired number of layers on the pallet, and the pallet is unitized. The wrapping machine ensuring the full pallet is covered. And you can see here the film is stretched to a percentage that we've set in the machine. That's the user interface for the machine, which shows you cycle, the speed, and the number of wraps. Now, the pallet is ready, and it is ready to be put into the warehouse. Now we have look at the PACML, the information that we can draw. Let's have a look at the line from PACML. Now we see from X end what information we can see sitting in our office. The production manager possibly can see all the process, all the machines. We have different modes. Right now it's in execute. We can see the line running. We see OE trends that tells you the performance, that gives you the production information. Each of the machine on a particular day, what speeds did they operate? What is the efficiency we are getting? How we are able to control each of the machine? Different modes, what is the maintenance schedule, all the information, the PACML brings all the information at one place for you, and that's the beauty of PACML, where you have all the machines interlinked, the connectivity shown on one screen, where you can see all of them talking to each other. That's the common language, that's the PACML.